Good morning all. In the today's session, I'll take you to the tour of the second session of DBMS. Before starting the today's session, let us recall the things as what we have discussed in the last session. In the last session, we started our discussion with what is meant by data. Data means raw facts. Then after we entered into that information, processed data is an information. Later, we entered into what is meant by database, how collection of related data becomes a database that we have seen. Then how to manage a huge data, right? How to access, how to manage all such things, how to store that, which is a feasible software to store all such things that we have seen in the last session. That is what it is, with the help of a software that we called by name DBMS, Database Management Systems. Right? Then after that, we discussed earlier to DBMS what we are having. That means we are achieving it with the help of a traditional file system, that is file-based approach. We are storing huge data in a file, right? Then later, we learned what are the advantages by using DBMS over file system that we have seen, the different advantages that we have come across in the last session, right? So now in the today's session, it's a practical session. That means we'll make use of this DBMS software, one of the flavor of DBMS software, because in the market, we're having plenty of flavors of DBMS softwares. That means different vendors provides different kinds of DBMS application softwares. Here in our session, in our whole semester, we are going to make use of one open source flavor of such a DBMS software provided by Oracle that we called by name MySQL. So here, we'll try to discuss about MySQL in the today session. Then in the today session, we'll discuss about how to create a database, how to create a table, then how to insert a value, then how to delete a value, that means a tuple from a table, that is row from a table, then how to add a column, how to update a values. We'll discuss all such things in the current session. Before that, we'll try to discuss about how to create a database. That means database, guys, it is as similar to purchasing a site in a DBMS software. Let's assume in the today's session, my interest, I am taking up one simple scenario. Let's assume I'm having plenty of movies. I want to store movie data in a table. In a database, I want to create one database called some MyDB. There I want to create CinemaDB, let us assume. Then there I want to store list of movies and a list of directors in another table. In the movie table, I want to store all list of movies with some movie name, movie belongs to which language, right? What is the release year? Those things I want to save. Then in another table, I want to store the details of directors. Then I want to connect, let us assume for time being, every movie having only one director. I want to connect this movie and the director with the help of some supporting attribute where it acts like a bridge between the two tables, right? That we called by name foreign keys. We'll discuss it later. For time being, we'll go with creating of a database. Let's assume this is what I want to put in the DBMS software. I am going to purchase a site for CinemaDB. Let's assume, guys, this is a DBMS software. In this software, I am going to purchase some site for some MyDB. We call it my name CinemaDB, right? So there, I want to go with creating some table. DBMS software name is MySQL, and the database is what we are creating. It is a CinemaDB. There, I am going to create a table in the name called movie. In the movie, as what we discussed, we want to store the details related to movie name, then what is the movie belongs to which language, right? Then what is the release year? Those three details I want to store. Let's assume this is a movie name. Then after this, this is a language. Then after this, I want to store the release year of this movie. Let's assume these three data values I want to store. Let's say I want to save some movie name is some ABC, then language is some Kannada, then release year some 2020. Then at this stage, movie become a table, then movie name, language, release year, as what we have recorded, This we call it by name columns of this table. That means a table basically contains, it's a collection of columns and rows. This is ABC, XYZ, let's say some English, some 2019. I'm having some data. That means whatever data we have recorded under this, you know, it's a details related to one movie. It's a data related to another movie, right? And this we call it by name tuple or row. Each row in the table, we call it by name tuple. And each column in the table, that we call it by name attributes. So basically a table contains collection of tuples and attributes. That's it, or columns or rows. But here in SQL, we call it by name tuple as rows and columns as attributes. That's it. Now let us will try to go with how to create a table. Before creating a table, we should know how to create a database, guys, right? To create a database, first I need to log in into my software, that is MySQL. This is what a flavor we discussed, right? We want to make use in our application, in our class, right? So for that, to make use of a MySQL, first we have to install a MySQL. Where I can obtain a MySQL? We'll obtain a MySQL in Oracle. Just go to oracle.in. There you can get free flavor of a MySQL. You can download it, or you'll get a, you are having a software that we call by name XAMPP, where it is a bunch of collection of many softwares. One, it contains Apache kind of a web server, and it comes up with one database server called MySQL, and even FileZilla kind of a one more server, right? So, and it comes up with a one more programming software that we call by name, programming language software, PHP. It's a bundle of such software collections, right? So just download that XAMPP and install it. Just double click on that exe file of XAMPP, then easily the things, all three software will be installed to your system, right? So let us assume, friends, I have installed it, that XAMPP here. This is what XAMPP window. There you need to start a MySQL server and Apache. Then after starting a MySQL server, it holds on port number. Then after this, come back to command prompt. Let's say I'll open a command prompt. Then once after opening a command prompt, just try to find a path to MySQL without entering into, because we are in a command prompt, there we need to find my MySQL software, where exactly in my computer that MySQL software is installed. First, I need to enter into that MySQL environment, then only I can, it allow me to create database, table, and many other things. I can do things with that. Now, I should know about the path, where exactly my MySQL software is installed. To know that, during the installation of XAMPP itself, that shows you where exactly MySQL is present. Now, time in my system, I have installed a DBMS MySQL software to a C drive, there XAMPP. Within that, I have installed into MySQL, there try to find a path till the bin directory. Look at this one, friends. C drive, XAMPP, MySQL, bin. Copy that path and make use of, change the directory in your command prompt and paste it. Look at this one, friends. C, XAMPP, MySQL, bin. This is what a path where in which I have installed my MySQL software. Then press enter. That's it. Now the directory path is changed from C, XAMPP, MySQL to bin. That is user HP to MySQL bin. It's an indication that we are successfully located that MySQL software from our command prompt. Now our next thing is, I need to log in. That means I need to enter into this DBMS software. Already I said, when we're discussing about the advantages over file system, that is advantages of DBMS, there I said, there is a some amount of high security that DBMS provides when compared to file system, where in case of file system, there is a lagging, right? So we don't have such facility. So here also, just locating of to a DBMS server, that itself is not enough. That means to a MySQL, it is required to mention, type a right authenticated password and user ID, then only it allow us to log in into MySQL. To log in into MySQL, the command to be used is MySQL hyphen u and root. Hyphen u followed by root as what we have typed, you know, that we call it by name, a username. Hyphen u indicates Afterwards, after that, what we are going to type, you know, that will be treated as the username. By default, we are having a root kind of a user. Even we can create other users also possible. Later we'll take up how to create a user and all. Let's assume then after this hyphen p followed by a password. But for a root user, have not set any password. So for that, no need to type those things. If you have created a separate user and you have set a different password for that, then during the time you should mention, for example, if I've created a user like Subbu and a password as some 123, then during the time I should make use of MySQL hyphen u Subbu, then hyphen p 123. Then only it allow me to enter into that MySQL environment. Let's say for time being, friends, I have not set any password and I have created a user in the name of, by default, what that user it provides, you know, the truth. Within that itself, I want to purchase this site. That means I want to create this database called CinemaDB, right? So I'll press enter. Look at this one, friends. Now the left hand side is what we are having, you know, the prompt that now it is pointing to, it's holding that MariaDB. MariaDB, it's a one flavor of that MySQL. Right, we are having many other flavors. So MariaDB in the current trend in the market, it is running fine. That means we'll make use of this MariaDB flavor of this MySQL. Don't think that I got a different thing. No, it is MySQL only. We'll go with creating a database called CinemaDB. To create a database, we need to make use of a command called create. Then after this, database. Then followed by the database name. Create database, create is a command. Then database, what I want to create is a database I want to create. Then followed by in which name I want to create the database. As per this example, we want to create a database in the name of CinemaDB. Let me go with typing CinemaDB as a database name, right? Okay, fine. Query okay, one row affected, like that we got as a response. It's an indication that it's a successful creation of a database. Yes, it has given an acknowledgement like query okay, I got a database. But still I want to know, you know, usually once after creating an account in a bank, what you'll do, you know? So is that account has created, I want to see what is my balance, like that you want to view it, right? So here also in the bunch of database, is there any my database like in the name of CinemaDB? I want to look into that. To see it, I want to know what all the databases are available, where in that bunch of list, whether I'm having my database called CinemaDB. To know that, friends, to know all databases which are present in my MySQL. To know it, I should make use of a command called show databases, where it gives me all list of databases. Never forget, guys, in MySQL, if any command or a statement, if you want to make use, that everything must be terminated with a semicolon, as what we have seen that in C programming rule, same thing we should make use here also. Look at this one, friends. It is displaying a plenty of databases which are already have created. But in your case, suppose first fresh install when you do, you'll get only two databases. One is information_schema, right? So that only you'll get there. Then let us assume here, look at this one, friends, CinemaDB, this is the second one, this is what we have created. Yes, earlier it was not there, now we are having this, right? Then after this, we have successfully created a database, even in the list, it is showing. Now our next question is, once after creating a successful creation of a database, what I want to achieve, friends? I want to create a table. To create a table, it is already, I said, creation of a DB means it is similar to purchasing of a site. Then after purchasing a site, creating a table means it is similar to a construction of a house. That's it. So when you go with construction of a house, where you will construct? Whether you will construct in a site where it doesn't belong to you? No, you know. What you will do? You will construct your house in your own site. That means to create this table, I also should enter into my own database that we called by name CinemaDB, friends. Now, how can I enter into my site, that is my database CinemaDB here? For that, we are having a command called use. Use followed by the database name. What is the database name, guys? CinemaDB. This is what a name we have given, right? Use followed by the database name. That takes us to a database in which we have specified with a use command. Look at this one, friends. we got a response from a database server called database chained. It's an indication that we have successfully entered into a CinemaDB. That means we have successfully entered into our site. That's it. Now let us start constructing a house in our database. So what is the table we plan to create? That is movie, you know. So I want to create. So for that, again, the command to be used here also is create. What I want to create? Table, not a database, right? Database is over. I want to create table, create table. Then followed by what? I should mention in what name I want to create my table. I want to create my table in the name of movie, right? Let me go with creating movie. Fine. What this movie table should contain, friends? Just create table movie, that itself is enough? No. I want to have these three columns. Look at this, just what creating a house itself is enough. That means four, just like a square, creating four walls, that itself become a house. Okay, but within that I want to have some other walls, you know, where it separates. This is kitchen, this is veranda, like this, you know. Here also same thing. I should mention, I need to have defined few attributes, that means the columns in my table. What are the columns, friends? The one is movie name. Let me go with writing movie name as one column. Even movie name, let's say in case of a house, it is a kitchen. Let's assume, just defining, I want to have a kitchen in my house, that itself is enough? No. Even I should mention what's the size of a kitchen, right? What type, I need to mention. Here also same thing, I need to mention what is the type of a movie name. That means for a movie name, A, B, C, X, Y, Z, something we are writing, you know, it is a text, it's a character, right? So to store this alphabet or alphanumeric characters, that means it's of a string type, I am having a built-in data type that we called my name varchar. Varchar means variable character. Just mentioning a varchar itself is enough? No. Even I should mention, as what I said, 10 by 20 is the size of a kitchen. Here also same thing, I should mention the size for this movie name attribute. Let's assume I'll mention 20. It's an indication that for the column movie name, maximum I can type this 20 characters, right? Fine, it's over. Then followed by, put a comma, then go with the next attribute. What's the next attribute, friends? Language. Let's assume I want to give a name as language. For a language also we have typed Kannada, English, something, right? So for that, the data type, this also of what type? String type. Once if it is string, make use of varchar, right? So I should mention some 20 as a variable character length. Then followed by next, what is the next one? Release year. For release year, I want to make use of only integer, right? So for that, let me make use of a data type called int. Int means it only takes integer values. That's it. Then things are over. Only these three columns I want to have. Then put a semicolon. Then press enter. That's it. Now I got a query OK as a response. It's an indication that we have successfully created a table in the name called movie. Now I want to see. Suppose you have already, someone has created a table. Now you want to know what is the data type they have used, how many columns are there. Only they have given you the table name. I have created movie kind of a table, insert some row. If you ask anyone, then what you will do? You should know first what are the columns it contains and what are the data types of each and every one. That you should know, friends. What is the length and all? What all the constraints are there? To know that, we are having one facility to know the catalog, that means the data about data. I know only the movie. I want to know what are the columns it contains, what are the data type, what its size, what are the constraints. To know that all things will be saved in the form of system catalog. To see it, we are having a method, we are having a command called describe, D-E-S-C, right? D-E-S-C represent describe. What to describe, friends? I want to describe my table. Which one? Movie. That's it. Put a semicolon and press enter, friends. Look at this one, friends. Now you got the list of things. Oh, it is also looking like a table, but I have created only three columns. It's showing five, you know. No, it does. It is not displaying those things. It is displaying the table movie contains how many fields, that means how many columns, and what is the data type of the column, what is the size, and any constraint, null, key, those are all the things are there, you know. It's an additional thing. In upcoming session, we'll take up how to mention a constraint, how to add a constraint, how to delete a constraint and all such things. With this is a system catalog. That means data about a movie, additional data, right? Data about data that we call by name metadata, and that will be stored in a system catalog. We have discussed about, we displayed a system catalog information related to a table movie. Now let us, we'll go with knowing the content of movie. Actually, we want to insert two rows to this movie table, you know. Whether we are having any rows here, any content in a movie table, let us first, freshly have created, have not added any rows. First, I want to see, it should not display any data to data in the movie table, you know, when I want to display. So then how can I display the data? If I want to display the content of movie, that means if you want to know the content of movie, I should make use of a command called select what? Star, that means star represents, I want to display all columns, that means all attributes I want to display from where, friends? From the table called movie, right? Then put a semicolon, press enter, that's it. Oh, what's the thing it's showing? Empty set, you know, it's an indication that we have not inserted any row, and that means any tuple into the movie table. Let us, we'll go with inserting a row to this movie table. To insert anything into a movie table, we'll make use of a command called insert into, yes, insert into, to which table? I want to insert into the table called movie. Fine. To which are all the columns I want? There are two different syntaxes. Directly I can write insert into movie values, then followed by the values within that parenthesis that we can mention. But instead of that, I'll go with so additional syntax where it helps me in creating a stored pager also. So insert into movie, to which all the columns, especially with auto increment, that helps us, friends. So for that, so by having a future thing, I'm writing this query. So for that becomes a practice in future. Let's assume, friends, insert into movie we have written. Then after this, to which are all the columns we are passing a value? We are passing a value for movie name and language, right? Then for the column called release year. For these three columns, I am inserting a values. What are the values that we mentioned? Then the parenthesis, which is followed by this values keyword. Let me go with always. When you want to, let me go with the further things. That means always when you want to insert a string, that always must be enclosed with either a single quote or with a double quote. Let's say for time being, I am making use of the double quote here, right? Movie name, I want to give a name like ABC for this. Then followed by, I want to mention the language. It's also again a string. Let me write Kannada here. Then followed by the release year, it's of integer type, so that it doesn't require things to be enclosed within the single or a double quote. Let me go with typing some 2020 here. Then put a semicolon, press enter. Oh, showing error, you know. Why? The error, because in the language field, we've used the spelling as L-A-N-G-U-A-G-E, but here, when we are insert into movie values, there we have made a spelling error. That means, when this kind of a column is not present, then during the time, even because the compiler making error checking, you know, it is showing some error. Let me go with correcting it, language, now things are right, then enter. Yes, now we got a error is resolved, then it's showing query okay. So with that error also, we learned one thing, there is someone, that is a compiler behind the scene, it performs error checking, right? It goes through the syntax and checks, do we have such kind of columns and all tables or not, right? So all such standard grammar things of that language, that means of structured query language, that all will be verified by this MySQL compiler. So now query okay, yes, one row is inserted. Now I want to see the content, whether that one row is present in my table. Then how can I view the content of my table? Yes, already we have seen that it is with the help of select query. Select star, I want to display all columns from which table? From movie table. Yes, look at this one, friends. I got one row of information. This is what a data we have inserted. Yes, let me go with adding one more data. Insert into movie name, Let me go with replacing it with a different value. Just make use of a cursor, that means arrow mark. Through that, easily you'll get a same query and just change the data. Simple, right? So there I want to have a value like some PQR. Then this also Canada I want to make. Then release year, I want to make it as some 2020. Yes, done. I want to insert one more row, something what, some BBB. Then I'll make it as it's of English type. I want to change this release year to 2019. Enter. Three rows we have inserted. Let me go with select star from Mumi. Yes, we got the data. All three rows as what we have inserted. Now, let's assume, we'll go one step further now. We'll try to find out how to delete a row from a table. Let's say, assume, friends, I don't want to have this BBB, this row, right? To delete it, we are having a command called delete. Where I want to delete? From table. Which table? Movie table. Yes, fine. From movie. If I write only delete from movie, then it deletes all rows of movie table. But my intention is what, friends? I want to delete only this particular row, that is a movie which is having a name like BBB, language with English, and release year with 2019. To delete it, I should mention how can I pick this row uniquely. To pick this row, I can make use of a movie name. Since we don't have a movie with a name like BBB, we don't have one more such movie in the name called BBB. So for that, I'll make use of a movie name. M name should be of which one? BBB kind. This I want to delete. That means this is a condition we have written, you know. Always these conditions to be written with the help of a class called where. That means we have to make use of a keyword called where. Here we have written delete. From delete is a command, that means a query to be used for deleting the row tuple from a table. From which table? From movie table, right? Then followed by, I need to mention some condition. What is that, friends? Where that movie name should be equal to BBB, right? That's it. Then put a semicolon, press enter, friends. Yes, things was done. Query okay. Now, what is the expected number of rows to be present in our table? Only two. Let me see, friends. Select star from movie. Yes, BBB has deleted, right? This is what we have expected. Fine, done. Let's assume, friends, I made a mistake, assume for time being. So here we are having a PQR is a movie. It belongs to a language called Kannada. For time being, I made some typing mistake. Let's assume it is not belongs to Kannada. Let's assume it belongs to some Hindi. So suppose if it belongs to Hindi language, now I need to update the value. That means I want to set a Kannada by a Hindi, a different value. To do that, we need to make use of a command called update. Actually, we are updating a value, you know. Yes, we'll make use of update. Update what? I want to update a table. Actually, even if I set a value from Kannada to Hindi here, it is a setting of a new value or updating. We are performing an update operation on a table called movie, though we set a single value, right? Update movie, right? How I want to update, friends? I want to set a new value, right? So for that, make use of a keyword called set. Set which column? I want to set a column called language. This language column I want to update in the movie table. Can we update multiple columns? Sure, we can update it. We'll take up even that example also. We'll start it with a simple thing. Update a movie table and set a language column with what? With Hindi. I want to have a value like Hindi. Once if I write only this much, what happens, you know? All rows, that means to all values, it becomes Hindi only. That means even for ABC also, that will be updated to Hindi. But actually that I don't want, you know. Only my intention is to set a new value for this Kannada. That means for this PQR movie, Kannada by a Hindi. This is what I want to do. To do that, friends, I should mention again a condition. conditions always to be mentioned with the help of where class. Where, how can I mention where I'm having a movie name? Look at this one, friends. How can I identify this second row? Second row is identified with the help of a movie name, right? Because here we are having, when I say where language equal to Kannada, updated to Hindi, and then wherever we are having a Kannada, then in all such tuples, the value will be reset to what? Hindi. That I don't want, you know. So it requires, in one or the other way, I need to uniquely identify this tuple. By using that value, I need to go with updating a particular tuple, right? So can I able to make use of a release year? No, because for both the movies, the release year 2020. So with that also I cannot do, because it affects the Hindi kind of a value will be updated to for both the movies. But my intention is I want to update only this PQR. So what's the left out thing? Only the movie name. With the help of a movie name, definitely I can update it to Hindi. Let me go with where movie name equal to what, friends? It should be equal to PQR, right? Fine. Then put a semicolon, enter. Fine. Query okay. Row matched. Look at this one, friends. Row matched one and changed one. How many values it set and how many rows it affected? That means this query affected how many rows? It's showing row matched is one. That means only one row matched with this condition. That means where language equal to Hindi kind of a condition matched by only one row, and it has changed in only one position, that is changed in only one column. This is what only one change has happened, only one new value setting has happened. That is what it is conveying for us with this acknowledgement. I want to see the result, whether it happened or not. Again, what's the query to be used? Select star from a movie. That's it. Look at this one, friends. ABC, PQR, Kannada, Hindi, 2020, all things are present. That's it. Successfully, we have updated. Fine. Let's assume, friends, I want to update two values with the same update command. That means I want to update with a single update command. Where to go with updating the language, one time update, updating a release year, one more time update. Suppose if you want to perform it on a same column or for a multiple column simultaneously with the same value, if you want to replace. So during that time, you can make use of a same update command. For example, friends, I want to replace this Hindi by some Tamil and release year by 2021. That I want to do it for a same PQR column. What to do? I should make use of same update command. I want to update to which table? Movie, fine. Then I want to set a value. Which all the values I want to set? Language. I want to replace this language. Language. It from Hindi to, let's assume some Tamil for timing. You take same any value you want. Then I want to change this release year. If you want to set multiple values, to which all the attributes you want to set a new value, you know, each attribute must be separated by a comma. Then release year or year, fine. I want to replace it by what? Not 2020. I want to replace it by 2019. That I can do. Then where, I want to mention a condition, otherwise it reflects in all columns, right? So where what? Where movie name is equal to PQR. That's it. Enter. Yes, row matched is only one again. A change is one, right? Let me go with saying a content. Select star from movie. Look at this one, friends. Multiple columns have updated with a new value, right? Possible with the same update command. The syntax is update table name, then set followed by that attribute name, then a new value, then if required some condition you can mention with the help of a where class, right? So that's it. So we learned, we'll try to recall what all the things we discussed in the today's session. We discussed what software to be used, then how to enter into that software, that is MySQL we have discussed. So how to enter into MySQL DBMS server, the DBMS software, that is database server. Then in the DBMS, how to enter into MySQL environment, that we have discussed. What's the command? MySQL hyphen u root. This is a default user, right? So with that, we can enter into a MySQL environment, there MariaDB in our case. Then after that, we discussed about how to create a database where it contains plenty of table, collection of tables, right? Where each table consists of a collection of rows and a columns. That means a tuples and attributes, right? So then how to create a database? Create database, database name. Then after that, we discussed about how to create a table, right? So prior to that, we need to enter into our database, right? We should not go with constructing a house in other sites, you know. So for that, what is the command to be used? Use database name before creating a table in our database. Use database name. Fine. Once after entering into our own database, then go with creating a table. What command to be used to create a table? Create table followed by table name. Then mention what are the attributes and the type, then followed by the size, right? So this is what we discussed, create table command, right? Then after that, we discussed about how to insert a row into a table, right? To insert any tuple into a table, we need to make use of insert command. Insert into table name followed by what all the attributes I want to insert, then followed by values. Within the values, we should mention what the particular values, respective values for each and every column, as what we have mentioned earlier, right? So that's it. Then if it is a string, mention it with us either using a single quote or with the help of a double quotes, right? Suppose if it is a string, no need to make use of it, fine. Then after this, we discussed about how to delete a tuple, delete a row. If I want to delete all rows of my table, delete from the table name. If you are very much specific about any of the row during the time, you should make use of delete from table name where with some condition, with the help of the attributes based on which you want to delete it, right? Fine. Then after that, we discussed about the last command. What is that, friends? Update. How can I set a new value to any of the column? To do that, we'll make use of update command. Update table name, then set an attribute name, set followed by an attribute name, then we need to mention the value, the new value in which we want to update, right? Then once if I write only that much, then it updates to all rows of specified table. If you are very much specific about any of the particular row, then with the help of where class, you should mention the condition based on which attribute you want to update, right? So that's all. Fine. Thank you. Thanks for listening, friends.